presidential election 2017. Result of nominations. Mdm Halimah Yacob is the only candidate who has been nominated. I declare Mdm Halimah Yacob
community groups, religious groups, and also members of the public. I know that you've been waiting here for a few hours and it's really very hot under the hot sun. So thank you. I'm really very grateful to you because you've taken time off from your work and really made the effort to come here all the way. I'm really grateful. Let me first of all say that I want to, from the bottom of my heart, I want to say a very big thank you to all Singaporeans for your support, your encouragement, and your well wishes. Over the last 2 weeks, I've been walking the ground very extensively. I've met many Singaporeans from all backgrounds, young, old, in many, many places. I've spoken to them. And I'm so heartened, I'm so really very, very grateful for their well wishes, their encouragement and their support. Many of you not only gave words of encouragement and support, many of you came to pat me on the back. Many of you also hugged me, you know. And many of you told me that you will support me even without my asking or saying anything. So that tremendously warmed my heart. And that also made my journey here to this nomination center all the more pleasant, warm, and most encouraging. So once again, thank you to all Singaporeans. Thank you, Singaporeans. And I want to tell you, as your president-elect, I promise to work with everyone. I am president for everyone, and I intend to serve all without any hesitation or doubt. I also want to tell you that although this is a reserved election, I am not a reserved president. I am a president for everyone. Regardless of race, language, religion, or creed, I represent everyone. My duty remains only to Singapore. And Singaporeans, my duty remains only to you. Although there is no election, my commitment to serve you remains the same. There is no diminution, even one bit, of my desire, passion, commitment to serve you. My resolve to work hard, to work tirelessly and with great sincerity is even greater. These are values which I hold very dear to me when I perform my public duties, my public service, and I will do it even, and it means even greater to me now that I have become your president-elect. Well, I also stand before you as the second Malay president in the 47 years of our history. I believe that this is a proud moment for Singapore. This is a proud moment for multiculturalism, multiracialism in our society. This shows that multiracialism is not just a slogan, something that is good for us to say, for people to hear, but it means that it really works in our society, that everyone has a chance to reach the highest office of the land. And this is not just good for now, but it's also good for generations to come, because it shows very positively how Singapore practices multiracialism. I also stand before you as the first female president. I can see that many of our sisters here are delighted. Just tokenism, that when we talk about gender diversity, we are just not chanting slogans again, but we really mean it. Every woman, every woman can aspire to the highest office of the land if you have the courage, the determination, and the will to work hard. Before I proceed, let me just say a few words in Malay. Saya ingin mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih kepada anda sekalian yang berada di sini. Saya tahu bahawa ramai daripada anda telah berada di sini berjam-jam di bawah panas terik. Dan ini tentu sekali menunjukkan apa banyak sokongannya yang anda berikan kepada saya. Saya selama 2 minggu telah... Terima kasih. Saya selama 2 minggu kebelakangan ini saya telah banyak berjumpa penduduk-penduduk Singapura dari berbagai latar belakang, dari usia muda, usia emas, dari warga emas, dari semua latar belakang. Dan banyak juga sokongan yang telah saya terima. Ramai yang memeluk saya, yang memberikan saya kata-kata perangsang, yang mengatakan bahawa mereka akan menyokong saya tanpa saya meminta sokongan mereka. Saya merasa amat bersyukur. Terima kasih saya ucapkan kepada semua warga Singapura. Sokongan yang telah anda berikan membuatkan perjalanan saya ke pusat nomination ini begitu mudah. Jadi terima kasih sekali lagi. Saya merupakan presiden kedua, presiden Melayu kedua dalam 47 tahun sejarah kita di Singapura. Presiden pertama merupakan Presiden Yusof Ishak dan saya merupakan Presiden kedua. Saya rasa ini menunjukkan bahawa di Singapura kita memberi peluang kepada semua, tidak kira bangsa atau agama, dan ini adalah suatu contoh yang baik bagi Singapura. Ia menunjukkan bahawa jika diberi peluang, jika ada sokongan, tidak kira apa saja bangsa kita, kita dapat menyapai ke taraf yang kita kehendaki. InsyaAllah. Saya juga merupakan presiden wanita pertama di Singapura. Dan saya rasa tentu sekali ramai di kalangan wanita kita merasakan gembira pada masa yang sama, yang menunjukkan bahawa wanita boleh meningkat ke mana saja taraf, ke mana saja kedudukan, selagi mereka mempunyai kemahuan, selagi mereka diberi peluang. Ini juga sesuatu yang saya rasa adalah satu prinsip yang baik bagi negara kita, negara Singapura yang kita sayangi. Biarlah saya teruskan dalam bahasa Inggeris, tetapi saya ingin berakhir ucapan dalam bahasa Melayu dengan mengatakan bahawa masa untuk memilih presiden telah berakhir dan sekarang adalah masa untuk kita sama-sama memusatkan fokus kita kepada bagaimana untuk membina Singapura supaya ia menjadi sebuah masyarakat yang lebih maju, yang dapat memberikan lebih banyak kepada meningkatkan taraf kehidupan rakyat kita. Dan kita harus bekerjasama dalam usaha ini. Tidak ada seorang pun yang boleh katakan mereka dapat lakukannya sendiri. Kita perlukan kerjasama semua rakyat dan saya berharap dapat mendapatkan sokongan kerjasama anda sekalian dalam usaha kita sama-sama meningkatkan, memajukan negara Singapura yang kita sayangi ini. Terima kasih. Let me now proceed in my concluding paragraphs in English. I want to say, dear Singaporeans, dear Singaporeans, dear Singaporeans, we have a lot of work to do together. We know, and many of you here who are workers, you know, we have both internal challenges and external challenges that we need to overcome. I ask you now, dear Singaporeans, that the election is over, to stand together so that we can focus on our core priorities to ensure that Singapore remains a great home for everyone. Dear Singaporeans, no one person or persons can achieve this task. We need every Singaporean to stand together, shoulder to shoulder, to achieve for ourselves the best that we can be. We have not reached the peak yet. Do you think we have reached the peak? No. We have not reached the peak yet. The best is yet to come. But the best can only be achieved we work together so that we can go on improving our lives and that of our children. I ask that you focus on the similarities that we have and not on our differences. I ask that you focus on the similarities that we have and not the differences. In 1965, when we became independent, no one thought that we could survive. But look at us today. Look at us today. We are Singaporeans. We are in a country that we are really proud of. We have come a long way, but we have an equally long way ahead of us. No one owes us a living. We owe it to ourselves to build a great nation that we all can be proud of and that we can hand over to our children and grandchildren with great pride. We must stay united. We must beat with one heart. We must move in one direction. I am deeply humbled to be given this opportunity to serve all of you. I look forward to working very closely with you, and I believe that we can do good together. We can do good together. We can do good together, and I invite you to do good together with me. Thank you very much.